Hello, 3D printing friends. Today on the BV3D channel, we'll learn how to add Elegoo printer configurations to Cura. Stick around and we'll get into it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. This episode of the BV3D channel is brought to you in part by these awesome channel members. Becoming a member is a great way to support the channel and has a few perks besides just getting your name in lights here. Click the join button to find out more. Hi, welcome back. Hey, if you're new here and you're wanting to learn about 3D printing, 3D modeling, and other 3D printing related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Okay, so today we're going to see how to add printer configurations for pretty much all of Elegoo's Neptune printers to Cura. I'm showing the process on Windows, but the steps work 100% exactly the same on macOS. No, for real, Mac users, you will be able to follow along. Now, you might be thinking, okay, but why do I need to do this? Well, for as good as the Elegoo Neptune printers are, Elegoo insists on shipping them with an Elegoo-branded version of Cura. It has their logo on it, and it leaves out every other manufacturer's printers and only has Elegoo's Neptune printer configurations in it. Well, and Ultimaker's printers, but I don't think they can delete those out of Cura. And the version of Cura that Elegoo ships is the older version 4. I think the only time Elegoo updates it is to add printer definitions when they release a new printer. So, from the perspective of a printer owner that wants the latest features that are in Cura, the best option is to use the current version of Ultimaker's Cura Slicer downloaded directly from the Ultimaker site. After all, they're the ones who make Cura, and that version gets frequent updates and bug fixes that the Elegoo version doesn't. But there's a problem. There's always a problem, right? The problem is that the Direct from Ultimaker version does not have printer definitions for the vast majority of Elegoo's printers. It only has the Neptune 2 and the Neptune 2D. So if you've got a Neptune 3, or a Neptune 3 Pro, or a Neptune 3 Plus, or a Neptune 3 Max, you might think you're stuck using that older version of Cura that Elegoo pasted their logo on, but that's not the case. NARUTUfzr on GitHub has Elegoo Neptune configuration files that we can add to Cura on macOS or on Windows. This adds configurations for, I think, all of Elegoo's current and past Neptune printers. Then you can set up your Elegoo Neptune printer in Cura without having to pick a close enough printer and adjust its settings. So that's the why. Now, let's get on to the how-to. The first thing we need to do is open up a web browser and go to NARUTUfzr's GitHub for the Cura files. For your convenience, there's a link in the description. This takes you right to the Cura Neptune test repository. Click that green code button, then click download zip. After the file is downloaded, go to your downloads folder and open up that zip archive. Inside, you'll see, among other things, a resources folder. Open the resources folder and you'll see four folders inside: definitions, extruders, meshes, and quality. Now, in Cura, click the help menu, then click show configuration folder. This will open Cura's config folder, and that's where we're going to add these files from NARUTUfzr. So, copy the contents of the definitions folder from the Naruto GitHub files that you downloaded over to Cura's definitions folder. Then copy the contents of the extruders folder from Naruto over to Cura's extruders folder. Copy the contents of the quality folder from Naruto over to Cura's quality folder. And last, if there's a meshes folder in the Cura folder, copy the contents of Naruto's meshes to Cura's meshes. But if, like mine, your Cura folder doesn't even have a meshes folder, just drag Naruto's meshes folder into Cura's config folder. Now, quit Cura and then open it up again. From here, you can use Cura's Add Printer feature to add your Elegoo Neptune printer. And as you can see, there are quite a few of them now. So now, adding a Neptune 3 Plus or a Neptune 3 Max is super easy. And in case you're wondering, I'm working on reviews of those two printers, which is what led me down this path to begin with. So if you're interested in either of those reviews, subscribe and click the bell so you get notification when they're released. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this episode. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool. Hey, real quick before you go, I wanted to say thanks for being one of the super awesome people who sticks around all the way to the end, and thanks for all the likes, comments, and shares. And an especially big thanks to those who directly support what I do. You're all wonderful for doing that, and I really appreciate it. If you liked this episode, a thumbs up would be great, and if you'd like to help support the channel, check the description for ways you can do exactly that. And hey, if you haven't already subscribed, please do. It's absolutely free, and it's an excellent way to help keep me making these videos for you. Well, that's it for this one. Thanks again, and I'll see you next time here on the BV3D channel.